Hello, everybody. My name is Sid Victor, and welcome back to Library of Runa. We're going to pick up a little bit after the last episode. Now, to set it off immediately, I found out that I need to be doing these objectives in order to gain the level of Urban Legend to the next levels and tiers and whatnot. I didn't realize that till after I had done I got done recording that one and looked at the footage, and I was like, how come this didn't move? And then I was like, oh, yeah, we got to be doing these objectives here. That's the reason why we got basically nothing. Although I can't necessarily say we got nothing for that last episode. We did the right thing in the wrong way, basically, because we definitely needed to get some gear and some moves. And I'm a really big fan of Brawl. Also, since the last time that we saw Coach Krendor and Netzach, I have updated their decks and also their key pages, so they're not so like horrible next time. And I've also learned a little bit more about the evasion dies. But I want to say thank you all very much for your patience as I continue to learn through the game. Again, I'm not going to be perfect about it, but you know, moving the needle, inching the needle forward is all the only thing I care about. All right, so. For the floral literature, complete a reception using pages whose costs are odd numbers. So this one we can do pretty much easily. I need to make sure that Maggie has to have some kind of odd numbers here. I'm gonna lower the chance of us getting any of the odd numbers, and just put them in here for Maggie. So this is what I've been doing, and I've been sort of like reevaluating some of these different moves and whatnot. Like Rampage, we could definitely go, you know, and I don't want to go too crazy, because I mean, I'm going to end up undoing like most of this. Let's see, Silent Knight in 2 endurance next scene. I like that. And Fleet Footsteps on defense, recover 2 HP, sure. And then Deflect, we can go for that, or Taste My Burning Blade, big fan of that one. Yeah, so neither Hod nor Maggie have any even pages on their combat pages. So we're gonna do something simple, just to try it out. So nothing too crazy here. We'll go back down to like, I don't know, who are these guys? Tane, McCullen, and Naoki. Mo, oh yeah, I remember them. I wonder if this works as well. Does this count if we go against the Book of Rats? I don't know, let's find out. Oh, you know what? I didn't know that. That key page also had 2. Yeah. So Maggie, and Hod are about to just go beast mode here. All right. So we're gonna use. No. We can go for Guardian. And then for Hod. Just go Brawl. Watch, it's gonna draw Skitter away. Actually, no, we should do. We should use Skitter away first. And I'm out of light. We discard that? Oh, you're still charged for the light anyway. Okay. Okay. Well, hey, now I know. Oh, we did play Skitter away. It doesn't discard it like that. I guess that would be unfair. You just discard the bad ones. All right, let's see here. No. Go for Rampage. And Hod got Brawl. There's a stagger from Maggie. Oh, man. We don't need Look of the Day. There we go. And sure, scratch that. Okay, so does that count for our mission, our objective? Let's see. It did count. Okay, so that's what we need to do. Okay. All right. So we have another abnormality suppression here. And we also need to view the third episode of Hod's story, which I don't think we can do until after this. So who are we going to have to suppress here? Ooh, red shoes, eh? Oh, God. I don't remember that being part of the shoes. The red is so vivid, isn't it? Simply dazzling. Prioritize targets with bleed. So this one rolls a 6 out of 6. Four to nine. Her second attack. Okay, Maggie should be able to dodge this. Then Hod. We're gonna discard all these pages. 30 stagger is weak to blunt. Got an 8 for max damage, 2, got a 7. A 3. So Maggie's got bleed. She's got bleeding on her now. Hod discarded all the pages. Probably shouldn't have done that, but you know what? All right. Endurance. Gain plus five power if the target has bleed. Holy smokes. Rolled a 5. Didn't get the stagger there. Got an 11. Did get the burn though. All right, Maggie needs this bad. Shylock, you're going to have to help us out. Okay, we can go a rampage here. Or use Guardian. Actually, you know what? Let's try Silent Night. And then we'll do Taste My Flaming Bat. Then Hod. And scratch that. Yeah, we're going to have to use it. It's going to reduce the die power, but we have to. I think this is going to be okay. 4. Got the 9 on that one, Maggie. 6. And 4, although I think that's actually dealing damage to Maggie. Got the stagger. Come on, Hod. Big damage. That's a 3, and that's a 6. 5 for Maggie. Yeah, this one doesn't say anything, but it looks like every time we attack this one, maybe we bleed, or that may have just been... I may have been imagining that. Okay, Hod got Brawl. Four to nine. I've got the 6. 5 turned to 7. And Maggie can go ham. Down goes the shoe. Okay. So the shoe is done. Maggie's going to go first. Or no, the shoe's going to go first. 4, 7, 6. Both of them are tired, so they both have to rest here. Okay, Hod's ready to go because of the passive. I think we rest one more time. Maggie can try to dodge this. I forgot about Shiloh. Sorry, Maggie. Max damage, unfortunately. She's out of power here. Odd's got the stagger. All right, this one was scuffed a little bit, admittedly. But we got it done. A little bit scuffed. We were definitely carried there by our abilities, for sure. Now I go to the red shoes. Hello, hello, got some fresh books for you. Hi, Roland. You're working hard as always. You tell me. Only our Miss Head Librarian can appreciate all this hard work with a huge reward or anything. How are you doing with Angela, by the way? So-so, I guess. She can be scary at times, but I can live with it. Angela seemed to be the most comfortable when she's talking with you. Really? To be fair, all the librarians I've met so far seem to despise Angela. You told me before about your motto of that's that and this is this, right? I've been thinking, and I don't think I can follow that. I'd have to loathe Angela with all my being, but I just can't get myself to bear any unconditional hatred towards her. Oh boy, that took a turn. I'm guessing it's because Angela has her fair share of tragic history and stuff. That's right. Everyone has their own stories, even if someone's committing bad things right now. I don't want to judge them based solely on the snippets I see of them, so I try to understand them in depth. Man, you're an angel. I wish Yasod and Nedzak were half as kind as you. Do I look like a good person to you, Roland? Don't know about that. Kind and good aren't exactly one and the same. Is that so? I wasn't really a good person, you see. Oh, is this about your first and second lives? I remember Malkuth talking about them. I see. That's how Malkuth put it. Yeah, you're right. My first life was a tragic one. That seems to be the case with everyone here. You were all doing research to cure humanity, right? So many people were killed because of me. Huh? You're admittedly a pretty good at fighting as a librarian, but you don't smell like a serial killer or anything. Do I? I still think I'm directly responsible for their deaths. I snitched to the head about the experiments we were doing and the atrocious things we were committing. They sent an arbiter to the laboratory and killed so many of my colleagues. When I heard the news, I couldn't take it anymore, so I took my own life. What happened there? I had to watch Malkuth, Yasod, and Nedzak died horrible deaths. In that laboratory. And what happened to a young boy who participated in the experiment? That's not all. We injected people with drugs and recorded the changes of the side effects that happened and made something within the city. No, the laboratory was in the outskirts to avoid the head and its mouth and the eyes. Now you can see that I'm not a good person at all, right? Nope, it's not that. I'm frowning because there's one thing about the story I don't understand. The head bothered to dispatch an arbiter just to take care of a research project that got some people killed. One that took place in the outskirts, outside the city limits. That part doesn't make sense. Are you really sure it was an arbiter? That's what I heard. It matches what I learned in the Lotomy Corporation during my second life, too. Too hard for me to believe. You're pondering over odd things, Roland. I thought you'd lambast me for being a traitor. Well, betrayals happen on a daily basis where I used to live. Besides, real betrayals tend to be a whole lot more cruel. Are you from one of the nests, Todd? Yeah, I was born in a nest and I went to school in a nest. The other librarians are too? Most of them are. There's one from the back streets and one from the outskirts, but that's about it. Dang, you guys are all elites, huh? You gotta wonder how you ended up living such miserable lives. And you had all the drive to leave behind the comfort of living in the nest for the research facility in the outskirts? That must have taken some determination. My bad for calling you a bunch of spineless snobs. We were full of passion too, which I ended up betraying. It means the reason you can't blindly hate Angela was mostly for an excuse for yourself? I guess I made a huge mistake once, but I want to be better now. I want to be a better person. I'm sure everyone wants to. At the same time, a part of my mind still can't forgive Angela. We've already spent 2 days on this stalemate. You're holding up much better than I expected. Of course we are. Did you think we'd go to sleep just because you told us to?
However, it's only a matter of time.
Or Huck, it's only a matter of time, Huck. That's right, but now it has the goofy voice.
Herc!
And time is what matters to you most right now. Our employees have sustained too much damage.
Our generators are at their limits too. I'm not Jack.
Put up with the play for such a long time, I could pass a day or two in an instant. The last 2 days have felt so long and slow. Angela, your filthy deed born out of your personal desire shall never be brought to fruition.
Arrgg! Yeah, the circumstances are no longer the same as before, Gabura. I'm now aware of the existence of Ego and its capabilities, Ahyuk.
All employees from the welfare and disciplinary teams have fallen.
You never get to spread the light for those 7 days you all planned. It would last, perhaps 4 days at most. And I'd be left with only 2 or 3 days worth of light for myself. In any case, none of us will have won this battle.
What is your point?
I forget Hakma's plan or voice. I'd like to make a proposal. I want to live, you see. Angela offered us a deal, and many of the Sephiroth were against it. Isn't there supposed to be a fire? Whatever. Sephiroth. Oh, that's what the librarians were called back in Lobotomy Corporation. No, they weren't. They're called Sephiras. The 9 librarians sleeping on each floor, you know. I see. Yeah, the ones I met didn't seem too happy with this job. I guess that's why you all hate Angela so much. Me, Malkuth, Yasad, Nedzak, and Hakma were the only ones opposing her offer. That means the other 4 approved it. Angela wasn't completely alone, huh? Be fair, they weren't actively supporting it. It was more of a deferral. One sec. Why are you against her offer if you thought you could eventually become a better being? It's silly, I know. Even in the middle of that, I was thinking I could repent for my sins with death. Hold on. What? You what? You're supposed to die at the end of this plan Angela ruined? Yep. The whole thing was meant to end us with us shutting down and falling into an eternal slumber, knowing that our long-desired wish was fulfilled. Geez, you are ready to really accept a morbid fate like that? You're always surprised over the oddest details, Roland. I thought you'd blame me for running away from my problems, even at the end. That's totally a natural reaction in my opinion. I'm not a very strong or spirited person, so I get why you do that. In summary, you objected to Angela's offer at first because you wanted to forfeit your own life at the last step of your atonement. But now that you had time to think things over, you were willing to give Angela a chance? Yeah, that's about right. It was rather a heavy topic for me, but you summed it up neatly. Well, things are about to seem lighter from an outsider's perspective. Thanks for listening anyways. It helped me sort through my thoughts, too. You're welcome, miss. All part of my work. Okay. Ooh. Glitter, obsession, and axe. At the start of the scene, each enemy is allured at 50% chance. Allured enemies prioritize this librarian as a target and deal plus 2 to 4 damage with attacks, gain 1 or 2 power and clashes against allured enemies. Interesting. All characters apply twice as many stacks of bleed. Yo. Axe. Slash die, gain 1 to 3 power. Take 2 to 5 stagger damage when a slash attack does not attack. Ooh, man. Okay, well, we have another librarian here, and and who are we gonna bring back next? Let's pair him up with Malkuth, or I mean Hod. Rob, hello, Rob.
Hello, every. Hello, everybody. Alpaca Patrol here. Coming at you. Victory cry. This is Alpaca Patrol signing out. Peace, fools.
Death. Because I eat off of paper plates on ally death. Well, that's almost as bad as being a Jets fan. On kill. Hi, I'm Rob. Okay. All right, Robert, let's get Rob a, get him his usual alpaca patrol goodness of hair. Eyes. Yeah, that's a Rob. Rob's a little bit spunkier than that. There we go. Eyebrows. First need to change the mouth here. Maybe the eyes do need to change a little bit. There we go. Okay, there's Rob. No appearance projection. All right, let's get Robert. Let's get Robert a key page here. We'll give him Dino's page. And since they're going for bleeds, we should try to get a bleed deck. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, I'm fine with that. Okay. Oh, and look at this. We already have another abnormality. Have an abnormality drop here, and it's going to be on Coach Krendor Netzak's page or floor. So let's see who this is. Ooh, Child of the Galaxy. Oh boy. Oh, good lord. Besties always stick together. Okay, here we go. Well, we can't attack the child, but we have the other child here, children. Okay. Pebble, restore 20% of HP at the start of the scene. Does not activate the current HP as 1. Don't leave me. HP does not go below 1. Becomes staggered upon taking lethal damage. After 2 scenes, recover HP equal to the HP of the other allies. If all allies have 1 HP, at the start of the scene, they die. Parting Tears. At the start of the scene, if there's an ally with 1 HP, including self, all characters lose 10% of their max health. What? The start of the scene, if there's an ally... Okay, so yeah, we basically have to DPS them down evenly. Okay. All right, Coach Krendor Netzak, we gave you all improved decks here. Let's go for a brawl here. Four, coach got a 5. And it took the only one that it could have drawn from. Good deflect by Netzak. Coach Krendor is still stumbling out the gates here. Okay, don't take loosen up. Oh, we can't. Got that. Wow, rolled another one. Team Netzach. Team Netzach is just doing horrible here. We'll get the free stagger damage there. Nonstop assault. Glimmer, 1-10 on the evade. But we have to use Brawl here. Big hits from Netzach. Rolled a 2. Coach finally did it. He beat a roll. Unbelievable. Okay. At the start of the scene, if there's an ally with 1 HP, including self, all characters lose 10% of max HP. Okay. So if we get this one... Their max HP was 40, so if we get this one to 3 and this one to 1, they should both die. My math serves me correct. Definitely go paralysis here. Netzach's going to act first, actually. Was a suppress here. Rolled a 9. Okay, and then Coach Krendor gonna come in here and gets basically no damage. Waiting. They're both waiting. Trying to restore light here. We can use Daring Decision here to discard, and we'll get a draw. Gang up on him. Oof. Coach Krendor with Fatal. Good lord, Netzach going off. That's going to lower everyone's max HP by 10%. Uh-oh. That included the child? Coach going Brawl here. Oh, he rolled a 1. No. Got the stagger. After 2 scenes, recovery HP, another eye. All allies have 1. Yeah, so all we gotta do is get someone down. So they're gonna do it. Let's just beat them for good measure. Coach Krendor with nice brawls there. That should be it, right? Yeah! Whew! Oh, this is getting real interesting with the mechanics of the abnormalities. I'm loving it.
Hey, did you know that art is inseparable from alcohol? Kind of like lemmings.
Oh yeah, I heard that. They say art is all about flashes of inspiration, right?
You know it. Maybe we're on the same page after all. I don't know. I'm Netzach.
Oh, you brought your different booze this time. Absinthe? That dude's drinking absinthe?
This is a liquor with a legacy that's so deeply tied to art, it's almost legendary. Since I'm in charge of arts, I could use some stimulation to work like a real artist on NetZach.
This one's pretty strong. But it's charming nonetheless. What if Angela Skull just like last time, though?
Yeah, we can worry about it later.
Works for me, by the way. Just thought I'd mention that there's no need to worry about a courtesy and stuff with me.
I'd say it's more comfortable for me to go out with courtesy.
All right, then.
Look at this glowing green liquor. It's just like the arts of the city. It's glowing and green. Kind of like lemmings, even though they weren't really green. They were cool, though. Cool like this liquor. Even though liquor is not that cool. Imitations that are provocative, but nothing else. Imitations of imitations, in fact. So I don't see any point in being original either. I'm likely someone or something else's imitation too. I don't know.
As if the stuff like originality or arts even matters in the city in the first place. Although self-proclaimed artists are nutcases, they seem to be mistaking any stimulation that's stronger than usual for art. Just like how I'm praising this drink as a work of art.
Yeah, the pianist must be one heck of a stimulant, I guess. I said pianist. Don't flag me, YouTube. I said pianist. And even if I said the medical term, that's not flaggable, so whatever. But I'm NetZach, and I kind of slur a little bit. I heard that it was music as hair-raising masterpiece that awoke this from Gray City from its new...
Well, the intensity was unprecedented, that's for sure. And some are still hung over from that performance, like they were slammed with a real strong booze.
How about you?
I must be one of them, I suppose. I never heard that kind of music before. I guess you've taken a liking to arts, seeing as you're talking all about this.
True, if I could choose to live a different life, I might have been a painter or something, or maybe a cartoonist or a pianist or Mathis, Crendor.
Painter, huh?
I'd be able to quietly express my emotions on the painting instead of just talking about them or dealing with them like an adult. Maybe I could have lived a humble life just like that.
How did a modest man like yourself end up getting involved in something as grandiose as curing humanity?
It really is a mystery. I'm not even sure myself. I think I wanted to be of help to someone, I guess. Like leading the lemmings and helping them not jump off the cliff after one another, even though it's fun. Kind of like drowning my Sims in The Sims 4. Have you ever played that? Yeah, the microtransactions are pretty predatory. And, you know, EA has made Maxis, not Maxis. They used to be a great company. They used to make Sim Ant. Did you ever play Sim Ant? Sim Ant was pretty cool. But once you got an army big enough to deal with the spider, it just really didn't even matter anymore. Just take over the entire yard. Not as cool as drowning your Sims in The Sims 4, I guess. But Sim Ant was really cool.
Oh? A someone. Perhaps your first love?
Was it love, really? Even if it were, it wouldn't have worked out anyway. But I was still holding up onto the hope that I could make something better. If I let go of my life, I'd bring bigger hope to some other person. I don't know, my tie's untied. That's why I participated in the research. That's why I stood against Angela.
Isn't it about time we ended the stalemate? We're at the dawn of the fourth day. If you're to drag on any further, I'll be left no choice but to terminate you all instantly. I'm with you on this one. We're never going to beat you at this rate. I didn't fight to spread only a meager half of the light. Ibira, how could you agree with her? You might lose everything. I'm with Angela too. Enoch's death deserves better meaning than this half-baked light.
I'm not willing to give everything we've worked for.
Say, Angela, if you're what's saying is true, does that mean... I really don't remember Chesed's voice. I gotta figure it out. Indeed, you and your employees will wake up brand new bodies.
Yeah, it doesn't erase all the pain we and the employees went through, though. It's kind of unfair. Pretty unfair. They're treating us like the Sims in Sims 3.
All our hard work, too. Even if this deal were to be put through, it would only delay the inevitable. How can we trust you not to betray us yet again? Betray? Don't be absurd. Have we ever once gathered around a table calmly discussing what we should do with this light? We haven't. I'll make sure to keep this promise, though. Both you and I require the light in its whole, albeit for different reasons.
Giggity.
I could use up this residue of light left for me right now, but I'd much prefer to have all of it. But I'd like to live more. I don't care if you want to die or not. I want to live my own life. And I'd like to learn more about the city and about this world we live in.
Angela.
Once you've reclaimed all the light, you're free to lay judgment upon me when that time comes. But I won't sit back, of course. That's all I have to offer. No one else objects. I'll proceed with it right away. I shall become a sentinel once more and watch your every action.
Yuck! It appears that we all have come to an agreement, of course.
Don't worry, I have no plans to let this be the end. Life will call you out once. We'll call out to you once again. So take a nap until then.
Whoever says out loud they want to die is lying. They actually want to live more than anyone, so they express that urge in one way or another. On the other hand, when someone is genuinely willing to die, they end up just disappearing silently. When Angela said she wanted to live, I felt something within me. I think I ate too much cheese or something, I don't know. That I want to live too.
No one really wants to die, man. They all seem to regret it moments before death. Well, it's usually too late for them by the time they realize that.
You seem well versed in that kind of stuff.
You get to see all kinds of people when you work as a fixer.
When I saw that desperation to live, I was reminded of the many employees who died right in front of my eyes back in the Lobotomy Corporation. They're just like lemmings. It's ironic how we were trying to save humanity yet couldn't save the people right next to us. That's when I thought, if I could live more, what would I want to do?
Good idea to think about your next move, yeah.
How about you, Roland? Are you going to go back to being a fixer once you're free?
Well, I'd have to think more on that. Still have a long way to go. Let's give it our best shot. All right, here's to us.
I can toast to that, all right. Here's to us.
Whew. All right, got another librarian, Pebble. At the start of each scene, three random pages in the hand gain Pebble status. Recover 3-7 HP upon pages with Pebble. Lose 1-3 HP upon using pages without Pebble. Interesting. Eardrop. Single ally. Dice power +1. On death, all characters take 50% of this max HP as damage. Yikes. Token of friendship. For 3 scenes, all allies recover 10% of their max HP at the start of the scene. That's pretty good.
Urban Plague.
I also got an achievement called Hospital. He says, I don't have a disease.
That dang old dumb with the ear, don't think thanks to you, can keep your position in the head southern branch, man. You're the same way too during the favor, no?
I know, brother, that was the deal.
What do you want this time? I want you and your crew to take care of the things on this list. I think I might be able to locate it soon enough. I can't tell if these are different characters talking. These are all ridiculous requests. Well, though we have the right team for this. Let me guess, Section 2? Yes. See, I'm a very considerate person, Thelma. No problem. The library is on the list as well. Now appointed as Urban Plague by the HANA Association. That's the one I'm particularly interested in, actually.
Roland.
Yeah, huh? Your estimation is correct. We'll have to thoroughly prepare ourselves for the guests from major syndicates and even wings from now on, right? That was the third most surprising thing to happen to me here. What nonsense are you going at about this time? Just call me Roland. Because that's your name. I mean, yeah, but you've never referred to me with my name before. My level of trust for you has increased, and I want to reinforce our amity. I tried referring you to a relatively more intimate terms. Is there a problem? Come on, that's a boring answer. It's been a long while since anyone called me by my name, still. The last time I heard that was from my family, I guess. Didn't you say your grandma disappeared long ago? Oh, I had a wife, you see. That's intriguing.
I
You're not intrigued by the fact that someone like me managed to get married, right? You're intrigued by the whole concept of this inefficient practice among humans known as marriage, right? Please tell me more about your marriage. Just a heads up, it's an overall banal story with some sad moments. Don't think you really like it. I'm always open for new stories with others. This is the one who won't even tell me the story of her own life. Can't bring myself to recount that story ever again. I'm simply too sick of it. The boring and trifling story that looped over and over for 10 millennia. Imagine reading the same book for 1 million years. You're surely grow to resent it. I'd choke myself by the tie. Oh, okay. Around the fifth time, I'd be forced to read a boring book. Anyway, I used to work my butt off. I had nothing better to do. I wasn't a bad fit for fixer work, coming from a rough background and all. As I kept working like a busy bee, I got in a house in a decent spot and met a so-called soulmate. You're such a tough woman. When I looked at her back, I felt comfort finding a place belonged to, something I couldn't feel even when I bought my house. I made so many attempts to try and catch her attention. Oh, am I dragging on too long? It's fine. Please continue. Roland? I did get a bunch of opportunities to see her, since we were in the same industry. My wife was a pretty highly graded fixer, by the way. She was dependable for a reason. Anyways, countless ups and downs later, we tied the knot. I put it simply here, but the heartache I felt in those twists and turns was real, you know? Both of us had piled up a hefty amount of money from working like dogs, so we decided to quit being fixers for a while and spend a peaceful time together. This part is kind of corny, but happy is the only word to describe how I felt, really. I was alone for my whole life. Finally had someone to rely upon. All we had to do was worry about what it was we had for lunch, where we took a stroll in the evening, what to name our child and stuff. One day I got an urgent call from a friend asking me to do a request far away from home. You can probably guess where this is going by now. The job wasn't a huge deal and the pay was all right, so I decided to take it. The lady who lived with me said okay. I was dispatched to a district famous for pajeon. I'm assuming that's a Korean food, which was my wife's favorite food. I could almost see her mouth water with the thought of eating it when she sent me off. To live up to my better half's expectation, I purchased a stasis preservation box from U-Corp. Present her with a warm pajeon that is straight from the kitchen. But a huge incident occurred in my home district while I was away. The house collapsed. My wife died along with our child she was still pregnant with. I cried for a long while, cursing this world and the city. I writhed and struggled trying to earn this happiness. Why does it have to slip out of my hand so easily? All right, that's the end of my story. Kind of stuff can happen to anyone in the city. It's only a matter of endurance. And you could endure that trial? I'm trying to settle on my own terms. And what was the second most surprising thing from you, by the way? Oh, that working here suits me better than I thought, I guess. Saving the biggest surprise for last. It's no fun to spoil everything at once, is it? Fine then, I'll leave you with sorting the rest of the books. You now transfer passive abilities. What? Through passive attribution, you can slot the passive items from one key page into another. You can check the list of key pages that possess the passive abilities of other key pages from attribution, known as enhanced pages, and see a list of key pages that are currently attributed to others. Simply click the list of passive abilities to open at the passive attribution pop-up menu. Oh, sweet Jesus. What is this? Step one, step two, lists. Step one, click a key page attributed to current page. Step two, list the community and passive abilities you'd like to use. Each passive ability has a cost, and key pages have a cost threshold along max quantity that limits how many passives can be equipped at one time. Also, no more than one of the same passability. Okay, so I assume that we can take... It's basically like... Assuming it's like any other video game, it probably has something to do with along the lines of... We can take the passive ability from, like, say, Walter. Like, Walter's armor and give it to, like, Hod or something. Or, like, let's look at key page... Passive in use costs 6, so we can add like get 1 damage upon winning clash, or three or fewer pages in hand of the scene, gain plus one strength. So, like, that would be good for, like, a discard deck, swordsmanship, etc. So, to me, that seems like that's pretty... Yeah. Oh, man. So, this is where collecting the passives and stuff goes. Okay, so that's pretty cool. So, we can farm pages to basically get better passives, and that's going to be... Oh, boy! If you thought Library of Runa was a simple game about deck building and stuff, you could not be more wrong. Man, oh man, talk about getting loot and more loot. This is going to be great. So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. Again, I'd love to see these videos get to 1,000 likes or more. I would appreciate it if you just go down and hit the like button on YouTube here. It only takes less than a second, and it helps out a great deal. Thank you for those of you who've been supporting the Library of Runa content thus far. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.